Hey, Ruka. See what I did there? How you doing? People giving you a hard time lately? The big pile of meanies in the atheist community jumping down your throat because they think your ideas are rather repugnant? Anti-racist is just code word for anti-white? Has it been rough for you, sweetheart? For those of you who are unfamiliar with Ruka, she recently made a few videos spouting her belief that genetic variations in humans, which make up what is colloquially known as race, constitute such extreme differences that make racism an understandable, if not rational, viewpoint. That because all people are not created biologically equal, and here I believe she's confusing the term equal with being the same, superiority can be based on such superficial and minute differences. She compared humans with other species of animals, stating that it is arrogant for us to believe that our genetic differences don't constitute as wide a spectrum as other animals, and that biology itself backs up her beliefs. She is of the opinion that anyone who denies the existence of race is some bleeding-heart ultra-liberal resorting to emotional pleading. She even cites the work of Arthur Jensen, a professor of educational psychology who has published work citing observed correlations between race and IQ, but not race and intelligence. Jensen has also received financial backing from the Pioneer Fund, which has been described as a white supremacist organization and whose tax records have revealed funding neo-Nazis and eugenicists. It always pays to do your homework when citing someone as a source. At first, I wasn't even going to bother making a response to Ruka. There have been plenty already, and she's not exactly someone I would normally bother making a video to anyway. She's admitted to being lazy when it comes to backing up her own statements. Plus, I tend to view people who hold such viewpoints in the 21st century like VCRs. Wow, they still make these? But I happen to find the subject of human diversity and evolution to be very fascinating. I would never be so presumptuous to call myself a student of science. But to see people like her twist biology to corroborate such primitive ideas about ethnicity, and then accuse people who don't think like her as being close-minded, is just plain insulting. So let's go through this muck. For starters, and this is just my personal opinion, I have severe doubts over the validity of what is called the IQ. The idea that something like human intelligence could ever be accurately measured by a standardized test reeks of BS. Some people simply don't do well on standardized tests, especially those who have not had opportunities for a higher standard of education. This has no reflection on their level of intelligence. Secondly, unless we're talking about the mechanics of the brain, the concept that slight physical differences are correlated with intelligence level doesn't even begin to make any sense. And it is no surprise that such racist principles find no basis in real science. Thirdly, nobody denies that genetic variation exists within human populations. That would be absurd. Of course we're different. It's just that we're all far more similar than we are different. In fact, only 0.1% of our DNA comprises everything that makes us the individuals that we are. Hence the utter stupidity of still relying on old world ideologies like race and nationalism. DNA doesn't lie. But our own eyes often do. But that's not our fault. We're humans. We're built to notice that kind of variation in the first place. Needless to say, I have a lot of animosity towards people who spout these kinds of ass-backwards standpoints, and not just for obvious reasons. I view them the same way I view creationists. Although their beliefs have already been thoroughly debunked already, they still openly pervert biology and the study of genetics to back up their twisted beliefs. To even insist that what we call race has any basis at all outside of superficial physical differences conflict with the general scientific consensus. Your beliefs are embarrassing relics of the past. Since the mapping of the human genome, they have been completely raped, pillaged, exiled, and left for the vultures to pick at. It can be hard to accept. We all look so different. Different complexions, different hair types, different hair color, different eye color, varying shapes of noses and lips. Even people with many of the same traits can appear so different, but biologically speaking, it's just an illusion. For example, here we have two kittens. What's the first thing you notice about them? aside from their distracting cuteness. The color of their coats is strikingly different. In fact, if one didn't know much about genetics or cats, it would be very simple to be fooled into believing that these cats are far more different than the same. But they're not. Even if one was a Siamese and the other a ragdoll, slight physical variations, which we have termed breeds, are biologically meaningless. Look at how different these two cats appear. Does it surprise you at all that they are litter mates? Just another example of how pigment, variation in ear shape, nose shape, and size on their own amount to nothing but random genetic chance. Ow. What? You don't want me comparing cats to humans? Fine. I'll be fair. We'll use me as an example, and compare me to two other individuals that look somewhat different from me. I'll just pick two at random. This man and this woman. What's the first thing you notice? Be honest now, it's only human to notice. But for those who haven't been educated in human biology, or choose to pervert it for their own separatist bullshit, it would be simple to mischaracterize the three of us as being different races. Being so genetically different. When in fact, the diversity among our DNA are so slight that we're all practically each other's cousins. In fact, we literally are all each other's cousins. Although in the case of these two people, hopefully not very close cousins. Because these folks are my folks. That's right, I may not bear much of a resemblance to either one of them, but these two sacks of meat are the ones I got my chromosomes from. So tell me some more just how relevant the whole race thing is, considering how quickly it can change and vary from parent to offspring. So, what is this thing we call race anyway? In taxonomy, race refers to groups within a species that have substantial genetic divergences. Lay people, however, generally understand race to be a categorization of certain phenotypes. This is simply incorrect. As I mentioned earlier, the human genome is largely homogeneous. As primates, we are rather unique in this way. And why is that? Well, in order to understand, I have to take you back in time. About 250,000 years ago, when our kind, that is, Homo sapiens, evolved from Homo heidelbergensis. Mitochondrial DNA, which only gets passed on from mother to daughter, and the Y chromosome, from father to son, are the only pieces of the genome that have not changed throughout the many millennia of human history, and it reveals that all humans, all 7 billion of us, descend from just a handful of people in Africa. You want to talk about tribalism, Ruka? Go back far enough, and every single person alive originates from the same African tribe. And an even smaller population, one of only about 150 to 1,000 people, left Africa to eventually populate the entire world. We know this because only the female descendants of one human lineage are found outside of Africa. This also indicates that there is more genetic diversity among African populations that never left the motherland than there are among all other human populations. How is that possible? Well, it goes to the heart of why humans ever migrated in the first place. We humans are essentially a hunter-gatherer species. During our first 100,000 years of existence, humans stayed in Africa because it had everything our kind needed. It's not called the cradle of humanity for nothing. But everything changes. Few things more dramatic than the weather. The last ice age coincided with the beginnings of the first human migrations out of Africa. Which makes sense, because the Arctic air in the north made much of East Africa bitterly dry, turning it into desert. No rain, retreating herds, our kind became what we would call now an endangered species. Our people nearly died out. We are all the descendants of the small band of people who managed to survive. Again, we know this because of the lack of genetic variation in our DNA. But evolution, which is simply changes over time in inherited traits, is always an ongoing process. As people left Africa, they first went east and into South Asia, and eventually continued on to the islands of the Pacific. The descendants of those who made it to Australia ended up retaining much of their African features because of the warm climate. Dark skin helps to protect against sun damage. Dark, tightly coiled, curly hair evolved from our hominid predecessors that have lost much of their body hair to also protect against harsh UV rays. But the appearance of those who stayed in the north and in Asia changed over time to help them cope with the hostile environments they lived in. With much of the landscape frozen, people didn't get a lot of sunlight, which we need for vitamin D production for building strong, healthy bones. Those who were born with mutations that produced a lighter complexion had the advantage of having a skin tone that allows for more sunlight to enter the body. Mutations for having light, straight hair seem to have the same effect. The epicanthal fold over the eyes in some Asian, Native American, and European ethnicities might have evolved to help protect against glare of the sun reflecting off snow. And that's pretty much all that what we call race is. Just small indicators of our most recent ancestry that developed over tens of thousands of years simply to help people cope with their environment. This whole race thing becomes more and more irrelevant the further we gain insight to human genetics. To place any kind of emphasis on these superficial phenotypes or promoting a silly nationalistic ideology are not innocent or harmless. All they do is create divisiveness among a group of bipedals that are all practically genetic clones of each other anyway. It's true. That's not an oversimplification. Our own blood has proved that no matter what you look like, and no matter where you or your recent ancestors were born, we all descend from the same blackety-blackest Africans who managed to survive one of the worst climate crunches in all of human history. So what have you done that is just as worthy of pride and acknowledgement? The fact that by an accident of birth, you were born with pasty skin in the United States? Get stuffed!